off of an LMQ game.
Yep.
Because I'm just going to flat out say it. Getting kills against them is very hard.
Yes. I would not doubt that in the least. We see that they just continuously dive at level ones, but get out with slivers of health because they just know the limits of their champions to such an extent that you're like pulling your hair out every time you try to engage it because you tunnel a little bit more and you flash for it and you do everything for it and you just don't get it.
My head's going straight to that Renekton dive in the top when he went middle underneath the turret. It's like, he's gone. No way, he's still alive.
He's still alive.
Got like 10 HP.
I don't know why he changed his name from Godlike. All right, going into this game here, Complexity Black versus Curse Academy. You can see Complexity Black is on the blue side first. A lot of colors to be working here with. But they are starting off. First pick for them after these bans come out could help solidify a composition that they want to take down Curse Academy with. We could see if they use it strong or if they are, as people have been at Curse Academy, focusing the jungle out with a few of their bans, making sure that Pat cannot help the lanes, and then most teams think they have an advantage in the lanes, as Broken Sarge said they did.
Yeah, and since Complexity Black have first pick right now, I would not be surprised to see a ban on something like a Lucian and then picking up Caitlyn for themselves so that Robert Exley has a comfort champion,
yeah,
and that forces Mashmi onto something else that he's uncomfortable on. Because we saw it yesterday where exactly that happened with LMQ, and then Mashmi played Graves and didn't have a great showing on there. So he's going to have to come out big with something that he's comfortable on. And they said that they think he's the strongest member. So targeting him would definitely be beneficial for Complexity Black.
Duosec did bring out that Soraka. Nobody wants to be dealing with it right now. A little annoying in the mid lane.
Yeah.
Could definitely provide a lot of pressure and hold you down to that lane for as long as possible. So we see the E being picked up with actually no jungle focus coming from Complexity Black. Seeing Curse's previous games, whoever they played against their opponent would ban towards the jungle at least once. So we'll see if Pat really excels on these. And they leave the picks up for top and support coming from Curse Academy first after the E.
Curse Academy more focus in their bans on the jungle, which prompts Complexity Black to immediately pick up the jungler so that they lower that champion pool even more for when Pat has to pick his own. So it's a good strategy by them. The first pick, Eve, coming out very quickly.
By playing into the hands of Complexity.
Yeah, exactly. Right into their But then Curse Academy, they get Rux's favorite champion in the top lane right now, Renekton.
Right.
He's so good on that champion that when he has a plethora of gold, he's like, I'll get a Phage. And just snowball, and then he actually finishes Trinity Force sometimes. That's just his style, is to just get rolling with it. And that's what you have to do with Renekton, too. Get early lead, push it all the way through.
He played against it. Up against Ackerman in the top lane. Didn't like it too much. We saw him playing Ryze twice yesterday. To great effect in the second game, but still with the loss, unfortunately. That's banned out, like you said, to the Renekton.
Which is
going to be big. Mashmi picking up Twitch, played it in his first LCS game, said he does not like losing on this champion, whether it's in solo queue or in competition, but he does get his Twitch. We've actually seen a lot of it wreaking havoc in solo queue to the LCS to everywhere.
Twitch is just a new champion that's coming out for people. Just bringing him back. Maria had it. KT Arrows played it against SK Telecom two times in a row, and Arrow was just like, all right, that's it. 2-0 for the win. And people are like, wow, Twitch is still really good. And it's basically signature champions. Like, go back to your roots. Go back to what you're great at. And we see it in the LCS with Wiz Fusion. He's like, I'm going to play Varus because I'm really good at that champion. Even if it's not in the meta, I'm still very good at it. So just going back to your roots, going to what you are good at. Thankfully for Rux, you know, Renekton's right up his alley and Ryze is banned out.
Yeah.
So there's no real hard counter to that in the top lane available. Pick up the Lee Sin just to have that mobility to go for more jungle invades and keep tabs on Evelynn would be great.
It would be great indeed. We'll see Broken Shard, like he said, really a gank-focused jungler. Loves to be in your face. And that's what we heard Curse talking about, is if we can avoid these ganks, then we'll be off. Because Broken Shard will still try to go for those ganks, even if you miss the first one. So you can kind of get under his skin that way. If you can keep playing very strong and draw that pressure, dodge the ganks, he will keep trying. So Curse Academy could get a little upper hand on that situation. But we see a lot of Protect and Shield game now coming from Complexity Black, along with the Kayle coming out. Maybe in the jungle as well. We've seen Crumbs do this, but Lee Sin is already on there. So he'll be flopped up into the jungle himself.
I'm looking around here trying to piece together all this. Westrise went with Jax in the top lane up against Renekton.
Perfect.
Ruthless Predator will still stun you if you have your Counter-Strike on.
Yes, ability.
So,
yep.
So you can go ahead and slice out of there and avoid it, or you could actually dice back in afterwards. So that matchup is a little bit favor of Renekton early game, but Jax definitely outscales it. And Westrise, he has that aggressive style. He's always played things in Akali. That's what he's really known for in the top lane, is that Akali. Just bringing that out, being hyper-aggressive in your face, Jack's right up there too. So looking at the all around here, you have a submarine engage here.
Yeah.
Orianna Ball on the Evelyn from behind. Come straight into that, have Morgana follow up. And then the composition here over for Curse Academy is a little more early game focused. And the fact that they also have that mid laner that came out, it was, jog my memory real quick. Oh, help me out here. It was Orianna on this side.
You're going to confuse me.
Kale. No. It's Kale. That's right. Yeah. That's right. It was Kale. So the early game there coming out with the shove and then being able to intervention, the Twitch is really big because the Spray and Pray is just so much team fight damage and then the Expunge afterwards. The team fight here, I give it a little bit in favor of Curse Academy, whereas Complexity Black have more of the late game focus here on this team.
And are we going to see now, obviously we have an Eve in the game, the 2v1, keeps tabs on Eve, also a Caitlyn versus a Twitch. Although Twitch can kind of harass with his Expunge and throwing out the cask, or the flask, or whatever you want to call it. Are we going to see the 2v1? Would it be more beneficial for that Twitch lane?
Here's the thing, too, is that Evelyn finishes the jungle very quickly. Mm-hmm. Especially if there's something on the other team, like an Elise, she'll finish it like 20 seconds before Elise. It's really quick. Up against Elise Sin, it's a little more even, and Lee Sin can invade and keep tabs on her, which is what he wants to do. But Complexity Black has been doing this buddy system thing lately, where the top laner will follow around the jungler, and I think they might do it here because Westrise has TP and Rux does not. You can pull off this sneaky move and get to the lane before him.
And definite damage coming to the lanes with the Doran's Blades for both of the top laners. We see that Spell Thief's coming out for Bubba Dub, as would on Morgana. But we are on to the Rift. The third place match begins a best of five here to be played out from Complexity Black and Curse Academy. Both teams with LCS experienced players on them. They know what it means to play in the best of series. They also know what it means to only have one game to play. So they're obviously, with that mentality, playing to win each one.
Yes.
You can't just say we can lose one and win the next. You got to go in strong.
Yeah, it's a best of five, and you want to start it off on the right foot.
Yep.
Get that momentum for yourselves, especially if you're Curse Academy, because then you get blue side second time, and you get to dictate a little bit of the picks and ban phase more.
Yeah. And then the game of chess. Mm-hmm. That's so it goes.
All those tactics, people don't really think about it too much, but Champion Select has a whole lot to do with the way the game pans out. A whole lot.
So it looks like Westrise does hover the bottom here. But like you said, the teleport on, this leaves it up for any options after he gets himself engaged or just hanging out in the bush here for the rest of the time being. Top lane looks like Rux is going to hold it. So we'll see a regular strategy coming from Curse Academy. I'm really interested to see what Duosec does on Kale here in the mid lane. I haven't seen Kale too much coming out. And people usually forget about little things of timing on the intervention and how hard you want to go in a fight. Forgetting that's up.
And little bit of just random info here. Last time I checked, Kale was actually number one win rate in solo queue right now, which is big. It's like something like 56%. But in competitive play, you need somebody to use intervention on. And a hyper carry like Mash Me
that's true.
On that Twitch is really big.
Allowing you to get in some sticky situations and get a very nice spray and pray off. Starting in the game, three in the mid lane to start this off. And it looks like Complexity Black is actually going to quickly shift that once they figure out what's going on. But it's only going to be for quick pressure control on the buffs. See how they work this.
So what they ended up doing is they put a fast push in the mid lane with three so that they waited for Curse Academy to show their cards, who's in the top lane, who's in the bottom lane, so that they can go the opposite direction. It's the same distance from mid lane to top or bottom. Now they're going to be able to invade, have a 4v2 at best here because Rux is in the bottom lane, and they're doing the buddy system to split up the EXP. Then they're going to fast push bottom with four members.
All right, so we're going to get the push on. They do go for the 2v1. Nothing has been happening in the top lane for either Mash Me or Pro, so they're just going to straight push to the turret. Pat goes over to the blue buff. Looks like he's going to be able to grab this for himself as his was stolen. So everything as it's unorthodox is actually happening orthodox, as it should, for a 2v1.
Yeah, in Complexity Black, they really pioneered this strategy. The Jax has a passive where he increases his attack speed every time he attacks. So he's got a lot of base attack speed at the start of the game, and the fact that they're on the bottom turret, which doesn't have the bonus to its defenses.
Champion auto attack.
Yeah, where a top lane does, they're going to get that turret very quickly. This one's at half HP. They're going to rush this down. It's 4v3 in terms of lane splitting. Rux doesn't know what to do with himself, level down, trying to farm the jungle and get what he can, and they're going to lose two turrets before they even get one. This is the buddy system.
And this is a much fast push, or more fast, I should say, push indeed here coming from Caitlyn. Robert X. Lee can just throw out Peacemakers. We saw Curse Academy wasn't really even to the turret with their minion wave because of the lack of push in the lane. Very hard times right now. Complexity back picking up a lot of gold for the team because everybody was still surrounding that turret to get the assist gold as well. And that's one big thing you got to factor in too, is that it's not so much global anymore. Who's chilling by it?
And now they're trying to get control of the jungle and rotate around. Four men now going strong into the mid lane. No backs here for Complexity Black.
Very close, trying to get another re-engage, or not another re-engage, but something to put themselves a little bit closer to where Complexity Black is found. A very nice lead in the beginning of the game with four mid now. They're actually going to allow the top turret to still be pushed. Seeing that Twitch is there, they have clear and easy pressure with Robert X. Lee pushing with Caitlyn in the backside, and with Bubba Dub hitting nice bindings, there's nothing they can do to get to the back line. Just like that.
Out of there.
Still getting good pressure though, Aiden. There's not much that they can do. And I believe that Jax able to hold this top, Westrice in the top lane. Mashmi's just going to kind of have to filter back with the team, and it's going to be chaos for Curse now.
Yeah, a lot of pressure in that bottom lane. Dragon, a lot of control for Complexity Black because of those two turrets. Mm-hmm. Now, if a fight breaks out, they can chase them really far and try to out-duel them, try to just win the team fight. And now, who's going to go for the dragon first is really the question. Because if Curse Academy take it off the map, it's really good because it frees up that area. There's nothing going to be happening around there. And also the fact that they would even up the gold.
So we see Broken Shard finally getting the clear on. That's going to be about a 10 minute and 25 seconds respawn on the buff. That's also not timed by Curse Academy. So if they can start getting that back to Prolly, he can also be the player he usually is for the team. We haven't talked about him too much. A very diverse champion pool. Somebody that can easily carry the game if he gets the chance. Playing a little game of protection here. But like you said, the submarine composition with the E may allow them to get the initiations with the ball that they want.
And now there's four men strong in the bottom lane here. Westrice is up farming top lane. He does have teleport available to him, and there's a ward for him to TP to.
Well, Curse Academy shows they can be just
strong
in the initiations. Right behind, it's Westrice coming in, throws on
a counter strike.
The flash leap into the fight. He's going to only get one stun, forcing the flash onto Rux. Broken Shard should be able to finish him off. A quick stun, and it looks like he dashes over
into the dragon.
Any damage on the dragon, and he does actually hit that. The slice and dice hit dragon for aggro. Broken Shard getting a little too far out here. Gets slowed on that, breaks the slow with W. Complexity Black quickly going for position. And jockeying here with Curse on Dragon, but I think they're going to be able to get it.
Oh, he gets it onto it.
It's going to be up. No! It's going to be Curse Academy. Pat coming in with the smite. Is anybody there for the safeguard out? A beautiful move by DualSec to slight himself in.
Robert have the range.
A few more shots. The flash headshot from Robert X. Lee. And the just pursuit of each team, bar none, super good in that fight.
So they overextend. They drag them backwards. I thought he was going to TP to the ward. He TPs to the cannon minion. Trying to get multiple people with his stun. He will flash. Try to get onto Rux, only gets one there. Stuns it, but it forces the flash out of Rux over the wall, and then he's just chased down by Broken Shard, and then they end up getting him over the wall. But over here, K1 Pro, he gets hit with the Dark Binding, and they just collapse all over him. Two, three kills coming up for them back to back, but they give up the dragon to Pat, who actually had a great Sonic Wave, just threading the needle on that one. Between two, straight to the dragon.
Little plays like that have to happen if you're going to stay in this game, especially with the way Complexity Black is moving. Curse, they answered immediately on what just happened, sending everybody bottom knowing that it would be a great attempt at Dragon. They were able to get Dragon, but they still lost a few in the process. See if they can still recover from this. About 2,000 gold down. A lot of Complexity Black. Very comfortable with their movements around the map right now. They're not really worried about pushing too much. They can just get back to lane and soak things up. This becomes kind of that relax moment where you don't want to relax too much, but you know you're in the lead, so you don't have to push yourself in any crazy positions.
Exactly. And typically when we see 2v1s, or I guess 4v1s now, things get pretty calm, but not when it's Complexity Black. I've seen them taking 4 minute and 22 second inhibitor turrets.
Yeah.
They just don't let up. If they see structures they can go after, they will go after them.
Oh, Bubba Dub didn't think he had to throw on the shield, and he didn't. Playing that one calm, cool, and collected. a good amount of vision. Wouldn't really see Pat coming all the way up, but I don't think it'd make a difference anyways. The rest of Complexity Black there, the two wards providing enough even if three members came up. So we can see Pat on his roam. Mashmi goes invisible. They may get a little bit of behavior reaction off of this, seeing that it's aggression.
Oh.
He gets the shield. Westrights gets hit up. And this almost worked out perfectly for Complexity Black. But in the bottom lane, Broken Shard finds himself in a real bad situation, and Rux understands how far he can go in that one.
So Rux, despite being in that horrible situation, has so much CS from freezing the lane at the tier 2 turret, farming it up. He's level 7 already against Broken Shard, who wasn't even 6. So no ultimate available to slow him down and give himself that extra shield. So the dueling power was definitely in favor of Rux, who isn't afraid to turret dive and build damage early on Renekton.
And he's building super damage too. He just went for the pickaxe. Nobody's harassing him. He's just soaking up his health with Call of the Meek. Doesn't have to go for pretty much anything else. And that damage pays off big time. That's their first kill and a little bit of control over lane that now Westrice has to pay attention to. Now Curse is going to focus on the mid lane. Once they get a kill somewhere, they're going to go somewhere else. Is it enough for Prowly though? Has a good amount of shield for himself. Gets that leveled up, actually leveling up the dissonance as well. So that burst power back kind of changed their minds about the whole gank.
Yeah, intervention was used there. Flash still available for Duosec. So was in a pretty decent situation.
Should have got that kill.
Yeah.
2v1, you should be grabbing a kill.
He got a lot of aggression onto him.
Yep.
Forces Pat back. But here's the thing. Gold is even now between them. Dragon went over to Curse Academy. They just got a kill for themselves, just got a turret. And the level advantage is actually in favor of Curse Academy too, because they haven't been splitting experience as much as Complexity Black has.
Yeah.
You can see Rux was level 7 when Westrice was level 5. He's just now hitting 6. Broken Shard also just now hitting 6. Mashmi is level 6, but Robert X Lee just now hitting it. So the experience in the overall is in favor of Curse Academy.
Transfer over to Prowly. That just spawned for them. Very nicely done, so they did keep the timer on it. As they should. We'll see how Prowly now goes up against Duosec. He should be able to just quickly ball move and push Duosec out if he stays in range. We've seen Duosec playing it really well in the mid lane at 78 to 63. Let's see if Prowly can take advantage there. Building up the Nash's Tooth already, or trying to get the Nash's Tooth, I should say, with the Stinger.
Oh,
ready.
He gets him.
Nice little jump, leap strike, counter strike, gets it off. A lot of action around the map.
Here comes Mashmi.
A going for broke moment here for Robert X Lee. 90 caliber net, beautiful dark binding from Bubba Dove. Gets the skyhook in there over the wall. And K1 Pro also being a bro.
Oh, here's Broken Shard.
Gonna make himself present in a 1v1 situation. Now 2v2 as the junglers come out of nowhere from both sides. Rux very low, flashes out of this. Broken Shard tries to follow, should get the kill. Safeguard is able to save him, but only for a moment. Broken Shard may
fall energy
on this one. He does not have energy, but he does have that bit of attack speed coming in from the passive. It's gonna help him kick him in the jaw just enough times.
And Eve is not a great duelist, whereas Lee Sin, complete polar opposite of that. Very good at taking somebody on in a 1v1 situation. And Evelynn, a lot of her abilities are lower in terms of damage because she has so much map roaming and pressure. So she could just show up on top of you, like we saw Mash do up top, just right on top of Robert X Lee. The heals actually haven't had to come out too often for these AD carries.
Mm-hmm.
Not a lot of pressure on them, and when there is, they have a lot of escapes built into their kit.
So Complexity Black focusing on quite a bit of kills as they're getting their lanes pushed, and it's working in favor of Curse Academy because these pushes and fights are coming as Curse has the lane quite pushed. Seeing the bottom lane there, Rux just about able to get out of a fight. Overall, going in favor of Curse Academy as Pat comes out on top, and we just see Westrice back down in the bottom lane. Broken Shard has kind of been roaming a little too much, not really providing a lot of presence. With the level down, it's really slowed Complexity Black.
Yeah, and the fact that we haven't seen any Feral Flares in this first matchup means that there isn't a lot of counter-jungling or emphasis on just stealing Wraiths.
Right.
But now we see Westrice teleporting the top lane. Even though Dragon is being done by Curse Academy, they want this top turret.
They definitely need to get pressure on the map. A very right idea by Complexity Black. The mid turret could be their next one to look at since everything on the Outer Horns are down. They're going to keep pushing on this one a little bit. If they have the wards, they may be able to stay safe. Mashmi, he's be careful, though. That would not be a fun fight for him for the first empowered smack.
And here's the thing, too. Once you take those outer turrets, you have to gain control of the jungle.
Mm-hmm.
You have to ward deeper. But if Curse Academy stays even in gold, there's a lot more potential gold on the map for them to take if they win a fight. They have turrets that are just ripe for the taking. If they even up the turrets right now, they would be ahead in gold.
Right.
Because they're taking every dragon. So Complexity Black, they need to start warding up. They need to start pushing and securing the dragon as an objective. There's equal turrets on the map, but if you're getting that dragon, it means the other team isn't. So you're just making the gold swing even more. Oh, gets it. Well, they got spiked.
I was going to say, little things like that really affect the game, but it didn't last too long. Rux was in and out, and so was Complexity Black. So not too much time wasted. Westrice was still farming in the bottom. They're keeping everything in mind as Curse Academy is making Complexity Black pretty much multitask right now. Complexity seems to have a bit in order, so they're going to start pushing in this mid lane. Robert should be able to take out the turret with the team, and this is exactly what Complexity Black needs right now because they've been sliding on their advantage early game.
Pat on the side. So here's the thing, too, is both the top laners and junglers are the only people who have died in this game. Supports, mid laner, AD carry, they're doing their own thing. Prawly's been keeping DuoSec busy as much as he can, just playing that CS game, so when they show up to fights, they will be the most powerful member of the team, just based on farm and levels.
A little bit of damage coming out of Prawly. You can see him focusing out the Athene's Unholy Grail. Very, very risky mash me play here. Seems Curse Academy knows the power of four without mash me is a bit strong enough, and he needs to get more items before he gets into the fight to spray and pray. Surprised they're still not trying to make some early plays or objective plays with the intervention on him yet.
Yeah, he's looking to farm up
so
that he's that late game threat. Because if you're going up against a Caitlyn who has superior range to you, unless you have spray and pray on, down bottom, it's a Tiamat versus a Phage. And if Westrice actually wants to go for this, he's level down.
Oh. He's like sliced out as soon as he attacked. Very nice timing. Complexity Black gaining a little bit of gold there with the turret pushed ahead in the top lane, making sure their jungle is clean. Three defensive pink wards make sure that nothing is going to happen without their knowledge, and that's exactly where they need to be looking and doing right now to keep themselves safe. Probably to clear this out and go back, so we can see the rest of the team is going to probably not try and fight. Bottom lane is being covered by Westrice. His teleport was used recently, actually, too. So
yeah, he used
no big
to go
engages
up top
from that.
Yep. And get that top turret, so they're up one. And this is that calm moment where not a whole lot is going on. People are trying to duel each other, just getting CS. This is what usually happens in the decelerated game after the hyper-accelerated early game.
Very good play. Rock's probably calling. He knows Westrice would not, or could actually, take him down. He wouldn't back down from the fight, is what I was trying to say. But he does now, knowing that instead of going in, Rux was more farming and said, I'm not going to slice and dice. I want to bait you into this fight. Very good read by Westrice, and he holds off the farm a little bit farther back. The pink wards are probably going to reveal these guys in the jungle. Is Complexity Black still playing pretty defensive after getting the top turret? A lot of damage has been done in the mid here on Curse Academy. Let's see if they can get it anytime soon. They don't want to get themselves in a bad spot. The game could be, right now, tilted either way. It's going to mean big gold.
And where the gold would come from is probably a team fight plus dragon.
Yeah.
I don't see anything erupting except for maybe just a little duel down bottom and a gank. Otherwise, oh no, he's getting caught!
What in the world? Robert X Lee getting a little too close for comfort on that one. Thought the caliber net was going to be enough. I gotta say, DuoSec did flash over the wall. He probably wasn't expecting the Kale to come flying in there, but
no.
Very, very risky play for an AD carry, especially 17 minutes in a complete mid-oriented situation.
Really far up there. Prawly was off in the back. He had a heal to speed him up, too. We're going to have to see.
Ooh. Wow.
Yeah, Robert blew all his summoners to get out of there. The exhaust was blown on him by Pro.
Mm-hmm.
But now they're just going to go siege up the mid lane. They saw Mashmi top.
All right. Bubba Dub on the outside trying to get some wards in. Pat. Still trying to go around and get that pink ward out for himself.
Now,
Robert
inside.
X. Lee still a little too close for comfort. Doesn't have the summoners he did last time. Taken out. Broken Shard's going to be hooked in next. The death sentence is real. The box goes down. The chase cannot happen. And Rux, just a little too late to the party, but more than happy to be a part of it.
So Mashmi completes Blade of the Ruined King, comes in from the side. They know that Robert X. Lee does not have his flash or heal available, so they immediately target him down, and they'll hook in onto Broken Shard. Eve has no escape to Cypher's flash, which doesn't even get to use. And now they're rewarded with the turret.
That was really playing inside of Robert's head. That's twice now in the past 2 minutes. He was just too far ahead, and they said if he wants to get a little bit more, because he can, we'll get a lot.
Slow onto Robert. The Black Shield a little late.
Yeah.
So he eats it, and he's got no escapes after that.
That auto attack on K1 Pro, too strong. Global Taunt, then they get Broken Shard. Very nice grab.
Yeah, and then the Dragon's Rage came in from Pat as well, just to lock it up and put Broken Shard right in the middle of the box.
Oh, the fight does go one way, but Complexity Black had enough members survive that one and just played a bit of the timing in their favor. They're able to take down mid-turret after losing theirs. But now 4-5 here. We have a 200, 300 gold lead. Actually, it's just fluctuating back and forth, so the gold lead is pretty much no one's right now because the dragon is very much alive, and it is very much about to be fought over.
Yeah, it is a very highly contested dragon right now. This will be one of the tipping points for the game. Westrise has TP. Don't know if he'll use it, though.
So much for being fought over.
Nope.
Let's take it out.
The wards were fought over, though.
Indeed.
That was about it. Dragon falls right into Curse Academy's hands.
As always.
Complexity Black, just 400 gold behind now.
I like this. It's not a both teams playing not to lose. They are definitely putting things on the line. They're trying to engage in fights. Westrise has been in 1v1s with Rux. We've seen the mid lane going quite hard. And just recently seeing Robert Exley get a little too antsy. So we're going to have to pull it back a little bit for the AD carries here. Mashmi's farming away, and with his farming away, still tied in. 140 to 138 there. So with Robert X Lee kind of soaking up mid lane and top lane, helping push with the rest of the team, he's staying on par.
We're going to have to see what he does. He's going for the Bloodthirster into an attack speed item. Mm-hmm. Not looking for the big ace in the holes. Up against Mashmi, who is just known for his late game hyper carry.
Yeah.
And it's great because Curse Academy always had this really good early game, and then their late game was suffering. They didn't have like the right calls or the right amount of pressure. But it's great that they have a Renekton who can win the early game in bully lane and then transition that into some turrets, and now they have the Twitch plus Kayle, devastating combination.
Robert, the Sub-Zero freeze in the bottom lane. He's just dancing around it so it does not die or go anywhere towards the turret. Well, that in the bottom lane is probably going to pull Rux in a little bit. We'll see where the pressure from Curse Academy comes now. Haven't really seen them doing too much. It's been the mistake of what Robert did, or just a few engagements that everybody was able to get out of or trade one for one, but they haven't been the one necessarily to engage these fights.
Yeah, Curse Academy, they really have a lot of the engage potential here. Mm-hmm. With the Twitch just showing up right on top of somebody, and then everybody will focus him, and you'll get a lot out of the intervention from Kayle.
Right.
You'll get a lot out of that. So people start blowing abilities on him. And the hard CC here for Complexity Black is really Counter-Strike, which is dodgeable from Jax. Morgana Binding, Twitch can still attack, and with Spray and Pray's range, almost nobody will be out of his range. Yeah. He'll always be attacking. You can maybe get a Shockwave to try and move him around. That's still dodgeable too. It's not a point-and-click type CC.
It's quite a hard team to Shockwave. You got Slice and Dice to deal with, and a few others. It's so hard to farm down by those turrets.
Just comes right behind
hard
you.
Hard times indeed.
But this is the type of vision control that I was saying Complexity Black needed 5 minutes ago, 6 minutes ago.
Yeah.
When they had pushed up, just you need wards in your jungle to continue these pushes and to have those safe type of ganks so you can get a turret for it.
Right.
Pat does exactly that. Now Westrise is split pushing top. Has TP available to him, Rux backs. So now it would be a 4-on-4 if he TPs to the bot lane.
Well, we've seen the Rux Westrise right now.
And oh,
he can stun him out of that. Very big grab from K1 Pro coming in. A beautiful job. Looks like it's going to be Pat to execute that one off for the rest of the team. And it's 7-4. Curse Academy is now trying to take a staple lead in this one. It's not much gold, but the map pressure being received here could be worth it. Westrise is trying to negate that on the top side.
Oh,
he
Robert
did grab the turret. I gotta say, Complexity Black is playing this one out very well.
Westrise
the
came in
to grab the turret. Westrise now teleporting in, and it's gonna be a chase on. Pat's gonna be able to safeguard a little bit more, but really the diagonal close on that distance with the flash is able to lock him in. One more, and Power Shot could be enough. A nice slow coming
leap
in from Duosec. Locks it down, forces the flash. Bubba Dub coming in just to the left side as Duosec saves himself, flaps his wings just as much as he can, and it looks like he will be able to get the safety. A
second
few
on the leap strike.
More heals. One more Counter-Strike to come in and lock him down. Duosec has to head to the right. Broken Shard able to catch up as well. It was a valiant run. Rux not being able to get much out of top, but no, he will stay. Staying on this top turret, so he's going to be able to get a bit of damage. How much focus of Complexity Black here is going to be used for Curse's advantage?
And Rux, he was chasing down Westrise for a very long time from the top turret, ends up giving up the charge to go ahead and try and farm the minion wave and push it out. Immediately, Westrise teleports bottom to that ward right above that tier 2 turret. Comes into the fight, leap strike is maxed out. already, so he just has it on a very low cooldown, being level 13, just keeps jumping and jumping and jumping and closing that distance. Nobody can escape from him. Even the Lee Sin with Safeguard, even the Kale with the speed up from his Divine Blessing.
Fights like that just kind of blow your mind when you're like, you got four guys guarding the turret, and the turret's taking damage, and you lose one. And then the fight's better for you. It's like your team got a red card, and you're playing a man down, and everybody plays stronger. And then the three guys started to push out Curse Academy. Then the teleport comes in. They need the synergy when all four of them are there. They can't get antsy and keep stepping out in front to get grabbed by these hooks, because they got the advantage out of that fight overall. The turret was theirs in the top lane. Just looked a little sloppy.
Yeah, and the numbers advantage, too, like
yeah,
we're talking about.
Absolutely.
It's just, it'll boggle your mind. You're like, how did that happen? They were down a man.
Yeah.
And now Westrice fighting Rux right now. Ultimates are on.
Uh-oh. Pat's on the outside. Wants to try to get him before using a Safeguard or Sonic Wave, but it looks like they're just going to chase him out for the pressure. A lot of love going towards the blue buff, though, on Curse Academy's side. Complexity Black looks like they will gain full control of the jungle here.
Ooh.
And they are going to start fighting back a little bit. All those wards have finally been swept out of Complexity Black side. You can see it's now only theirs, so they should start as they are, placing them on Curse's side.
Dragon is up in 20 seconds. Westrice will not have his teleport. He's keeping tabs on Pat, who was up in the top lane. He saw him there. He's trying to at least put some pressure on and keep him there, but it doesn't look like it's going to last for long. Pat roaming around the jungle with Mash, but they're on the opposite side of the Dragon. Red buff for Dragon, I don't think that's an even trade.
Probably not. We'll see if the rotation comes in quite quick. Teleport's still down, but Westrice more than happy to stay in the top lane and create all that pressure. They're going to start Curse thinking twice. 2,000 gold lead is pretty much the most we've seen so far. Zyrene, that gets extended just a little bit over 2,000 with that kill of the Dragon. Looking at the CS leads. Look at these lanes. So even across the board.
So a lot of this pressure that Complexity Black have been able to create is because of the teleport and the fact that Rux doesn't have one himself. He has Ignite, he's going to win the lane, but he didn't really have a lane for the first parts of the game.
Right.
And right now, his lane is always pushed in on him, but that's where teleport is one of the best summoner spells at your disposal.
Yeah.
Dueling a Jax, he does need the Ignite to at least duel him, or else Westrice would just go all over him, trample him down, and be like, all right, now your turret's in my sight. So it's kind of a really difficult situation when you're up against this Jax who's already completed two items and has the mobility summoner spell and map pressure.
A lot of possibilities for both teams that hit hooks or dark bindings that's going to initiate the right fight. There's one and two. Just missed it off the side. So not the right fight just yet. We're 26 minutes in, and it's definitely getting tense for both teams. The Lich Bane, along with the Nashers, finished out for Duosec. He's going to start hurting champions as well as the turrets. We haven't really seen Curse Academy approach objectives, not objectives, but the turrets anytime soon. They're going to start going down real quick.
Yeah, and it's a complete bloodbath. Everybody's going for these kills. They're even nobody giving the other one really any wiggle room either. And you're seeing how hard these guys want to be an LCS qualifier.
Deja vu.
But here comes Broken Shard to the top lane. If that Q lands.
Oh, it did. I don't think he wanted it to land either after he saw what was on the other side. Both guys back out, knowing it probably would have just been an elongated fight with everybody walking out bleeding, and then nobody would be able to push. And they want to push. People want pressure right now.
You still get some things off of an elongated fight where you get people low. Like if they got Broken Shard very low, they could possibly contest the Baron. Make Westrice back. He does have TP now. And Mash Me, he's sneaking around.
Very interesting. Both the ADs going for the static shiv this game.
Oh, that was cute. He threw a cask in there, and then he saw it from his own pink ward.
I think he plays Twitch.
Yeah. Well, there's a pink ward in there, so he was like, all right, let's just throw it at it and go after it.
Locking it down.
It's right there!
7-7 are the kills. 2,300 gold. In the lead is Complexity Black, but it is really not showing anywhere. Map control is the name of the game right now. Complexity Black is trying to dictate that to the mid lane. Not too many forward wards for themselves to get into dangerous positions. And Curse is making sure that nothing goes past the river. I don't know how often these minion waves just keep resetting in the mid lane. Top lane about to have that same thing happen. Pat gets a good push on it. But mid lane is the focus, Zyrene. Second tier turrets have to go down sometime.
Yeah, and I was looking at the gold generation items here. We see the Talisman of Ascension was actually very recently picked up and has only earned 60 gold. For Bubba Dub, whereas there isn't any type of gold generation item
right.
on K1 Pro.
And he was already cashing in on the Spell Thieves before that.
Exactly. So he was swapping it over immediately. Mm-hmm. So some of this gold is actually from the Spell Thief's Edge that Bubba Dub was having. And then he doesn't want the Frost Queen's Claim. He says, I don't need that. We need the engage. We need the movement here.
Yeah.
Positioning. Because K1 Pro doesn't have an item like that at his disposal, the mobility advantage once again goes to Complexity Black.
I think it's an all-out fight, pretty much. The Frost Queen's Claim is going to be used, and everybody's going to stay in the fight. Rux is getting chased out here. A little bit of a Blade of the Rune King to keep himself safe.
Westrice dragged two to
yes,
him,
he did.
Which means that it's 3v4 in the mid, but Pat's off on the side. Can he come around and get a good kick into something? Broken Shard's on duty, though.
Kick of the century. If he can get around, he gets himself a nice... Oh, he kicked the shield! Robert X Lee takes it fully, but he still gets the kill going in onto Bubba Dub. A good fight so far coming in for Curse Academy. Westrice on the backside, and they are getting good heals over to everybody. And Mikhail's quickly saving one. Pat... That threaded the needle, but he was able to flex enough to get himself to safety. A great grab out of Broly. He's
so going
to get
damage.
Rocked. Westrice tries to go back in as well as they go a retribution kill on each other. One
oh
more
my
kick.
God.
Westrice is just playing hopscotch on people's heads
here's
right
Mashby.
Now.
He's got
he
the poison on the Westrice.
He gets the passive. Oh my God, so close.
Oh,
Robert
he gets them both.
Gets hit down, and the expunge is able to cancel out both on either side of him.
And he's looking for more. He's so fast, though. We're looking at that again. He ends up kicking Robert, who's immune. Could have gone way worse. And the Shockwave hits three. It was really good there with the Agony's Embrace on top. Westrice is off on the side. He's waiting. Jumps in, dunks Duo Seg. Pat flashes straight onto a trap. He gets Mikhail's out of it. But then he threads the needle on it. So he's just low enough. And Westrice says, all right, he has to back off. Now K1 Pro is my target. Goes straight after him, dunks him. But meanwhile, probably gets taken out by Rux. And here comes Mashme. They don't recognize the damage that he's doing. When Westrice jumps back in, he picks up the kill for himself, but look at this. He swaps it over to Robert, who has turret aggro. He takes another shot, and boom. Double kill from his poison.
Great job by Westrice. In that fight, always being a constant pressure on the backside. It's like the team could have turned on him in 1 second. But overall, Mashme really kind of winning out there in the end. I'm sure he's quite happy with what just happened.
Both teams played that extraordinarily well.
Yeah.
The black shield onto the kick, it would have been a great kick. Black
I'm sure
shield
how the turret
that.
Is still up.
Yeah.
That's a little
and
weird.
That too. And also at the same time, the shockwave from Prawly hitting three was really good considering he only could have possibly locked up four targets in that because Pat was nowhere near it. And now the dragon's up and they are going to have to contest this. Ultimates are up. It's time to rumble.
I like it. This is like the hard mode fight. Summoners are down, but all the ultimates and abilities are up, so you're really testing who's can put it on the line right now. Going for Broken, the dragon fight is going to mean a lot. 31 minutes into the game, a lockdown onto Rux. Big damage onto the dragon. They're able to slay that one. More gold in the favor of Curse Academy as they are only 600 gold in the lead, which means this fight
Mashby's
is neck
waiting for
and
it.
Neck. Westrice jumps
he's
in
right
once
on
again in the team. Mashme goes down instantly, pulls him in with Command Shockwave to give Westrice another one. Prowley's going to be on the backside, shielding himself from Twitch's passive poison. Gives it back as well for another dissonance, and Westrice is still going to town. K1 Pro and Duosec on the outside trying to assess the rest of the fight, but they have three members lost to just Robert X Lee, and Westrice is still hungry.
Pat gave
Maybe
it away.
Not.
Pat gave away the location of Mashme. Watch this, Westrice? He's like, I'm going to go after Pat. I'm going to go after Pat. Watch this.
He's still
Safeguards
invisible.
Safeguards to Mashme.
Yeah.
And he jumps right on him. He gave it away. Mashme was looking for the lockup there. And then immediately the shockwave on top of that. Probably he's going to go down here, but boom, shield right to himself. And they end up picking up Rux here too, just re-engage the fight. And then Broken Shard looked like he wanted more, but he was full.
That... There's such a return on gold in that, too, because Mashme just got himself a bunch of kills. Not what they needed to have happen. Dragon did go down to Pat. They're able to still control that, the map control, somewhat in their favor after that fight. We're still going to have to see how it pans out. But it's 13 to 12. As bloody as everything looks, it's only about a 1,300 gold lead.
Oh,
still
Mashme.
5 to 4 in turrets. Oop. And he is playing with fire right now. Tries to go for it. The expunge cannot be canceled out. The rest of the team was there. He knew the capabilities of the rest of the team and how far they had to gap close. Bubba Dub's going to be going down on this one. The red buff continuously hitting up on him. A 1-2-3 and the soul shackles won't even matter as they send him to the other side. And the turret in the mid going down. After all that, Curse's second tier mid still stands.
And now they're up 600 gold. They could possibly go for a Baron here, but Broken Shard's still up. West Rice, a huge threat, still trying to split push. But Mashmi, he will decimate it. He has a Blade of the Ruined King, and he's Twitch. He's got a lot of innate attack speed. West Rice, he says, you know what? I want that tier two.
Yeah, it doesn't still stand.
At the very least.
Making moves they need to make. The team's going to be pinching in here onto the Baron's Irene. Agony's Embrace goes down. They throw into West Rice, trying to get the stun up, but they're trying to also separate themselves
from Baron.
Oh, but Mashmi's
out on the outside.
Kill going down onto Broken Shard. That's going to be West Rice down as well. A nice shot from Prowley on the outside. Is able to take down Mashmi, but he's not necessary for this Baron takedown, and he's not necessary to be up either with the amount of strength their team has now in those stats.
Mashmi's such a high-priority target that as soon as he showed himself, everybody swapped. And the Shockwave could be in a great position here at the very start, but Mashmi's not in there. Watch how Prowley holds on to it forever. He's like, I'm not going to Shockwave unless I get Mashmi. So then he throws it over to him to use it now, because it looked like he could have gotten three there, right? And a lot of damage.
He waited on it too.
Yeah.
He knew there was no movement.
He only wanted to use it on Mash.
Yep.
That's the priority target here. And Mashmi doesn't get Baron buff, so maybe they're saying worth, but at the same time, everybody else has it now.
I can't believe how ridiculously close this game is. I mean, look at the CS. Look at the kills. 2-2 and 8 to a 2-2 and 7. Like, that's crazy. Especially the CS. The gold, the kills, the turrets, this game is outrageous. The third place match is real, and it's coming in strong for the first game of the day. This is a best of five, and I expect it to go to 9.
And look at how strong West Rice is. He's 1,300 gold. Wow. Sorry, 1,400 gold.
Yeah.
Mashmi's 1,300. Those are the two people here that are linchpins for either of these teams.
Yep.
If West Rice can make it onto Mashmi without anybody helping him, like when Pat safeguarded to it, it was just a dead giveaway. You do not want to do that. So if Mashmi can position himself like he did that last fight, completely out of the team, and make Prowley second guess his Shockwaves, that's exactly what he needs to do.
West Rice, definitely a heavyweight coming in for Complexity Black right now. He has been dictating how these fights work all throughout with his positioning. Let's see what they can do. Complexity Black had quite a rough early game throughout 5 to 7 minutes. Seemed like they were a bit lackadaisical with the warding in their jungle. They had perfect warding, but weren't pressuring.
So here's the thing, they're giving up the turret, but West Rice, he's pushing. Rux is trying to back, and Complexity Black, they aren't going to try to stop it, but now it's that situation where if West Rice can get away from Rux, he can TP in and they can fight. If they go for it. But it looks like Complexity Black have other plans.
The Infinity Edge has just been completed for Mash. It's going to be huge, too, if Rux can get himself to these fights. The Black Cleaver, if he slice and dices the team, just shredding Cold and Meek, Spray and Pray after that, see you later. That's going to be so much damage that these guys have. Like you said before, the safety coming from Duosec on that that's going to be able to help. Curse Academy has their fight set in order to make this happen, but we've seen what West Rice can do. We've seen what happens if Complexity Black kind of plays the fight a little wrong and things go wrong. They still come out on top. They'll take either a turret in the end or they'll make sure it's a 1-for-2 takedown, and they only lost Robert X. Lee because there was just too much focus on him. It's a crazy game right now. Curse Academy has the fights. Complexity's been winning them, but now nobody's got past the front of the base.
Yeah, it's all these just inhibitor turrets up here for both sides. Six turrets.
Yeah.
And now the pressure's on. You have to get the warding that you want. You have to get the objectives that you want. Curse Academy still has the Baron for a little bit longer. Dragon up in 15, and now they're sieging with West Rice in the bottom lane.
Is big. Should be able to hold. Not too much of a problem here. The Peacemakers into the Dissonance, being able to clear out the waves. You can still see Rux getting himself a little bit ahead. Very cheeky plays coming in.
Going after West Rice.
Yeah, he teleported in and they saw it right away.
Oh!
It's going to be the engage. Bubba Dub very low. Gets hit up by Mashmi right on the backside. Spray and Pray. He's in the perfect choke point to keep shredding the team.
But Duosec.
With a beautiful flash in the save. God. I don't even know how that saved him just now. 18 to 14. 38 minutes on the clock, and Mashmi's got his eyes on the inhibitor turret.
Oh, but they're going after him right now. He's trying to get out of this. It's so close. He wants the stealth.
He thought he was the winner in the game of cat and mouse, and nobody saw him over there, but the entire team had eyes on him. It was a little too much focus, though. The tunnel to mid leaves the top open, and Curse Academy is still wreaking havoc after a chaotic fight that went from mid back to the top lane, and now it looks like we might get a breather.
And now trying to chase him down. Inhibitor goes down as well. He's trying to re-engage.
Oh, Pat. Very, very risky move here.
Kicks Robert in.
Get DualSec on the backside. Close enough. Yes. Robert a little too close with the kick in. Finds himself at the wrong place at the wrong time due to the hands of Pat.
Now, that mid lane turret has some damage on it. Curse Academy up. And now we're going to take another look at this. Rux gets caught. But West Rice, he's trying to pincer. He's on the wrong side of this fight. They disengage, start collapsing on him. Then, boom, he gets locked up. Box is there. He gets kicked over it, exhausted. And then he's like, I should go for Mash Me. Tries to go for it, but Bubba Dub is down. And he's like, all right, I better disengage. Now the Shockwave comes out, doesn't even hit Mash Me. Duosec gets very low, heals himself.
Oh my word.
And Rux also very low. He gets Mikhail's off on the side, and here it goes, right into it. He almost dodged it, but it was for the shield to go ahead and give it to Duosec. So the shield would have saved him regardless.
Pretty sweet indeed. But it lived through the whole entire thing. Still looks good. Two thumbs up. 19-15 on the scoreboard, and I think that was our big tilt there, Zyrene.
Yeah.
4,000 gold lead now coming in strong for Curse Academy. They are using it well with just a few hundred gold in the lead. Now that's going to be a lot of completed items that are required. Duosec has double invincibility for himself now with Zhonya's and the intervention to come out. Randuin's upon Randuin's to continue the fight from both teams. So we're going to get a long one. It's still a kind of, I feel like it's a toss-up depending on how the crowd control is on use on Complexity's side here. That was a perfect fight in the choke point they gave Mash. They can't do that.
Peeling for Mash, having the intervention for him just in case somebody gets on him, but it doesn't look like that's going to happen. Mash has such great positioning, and the fact that he's done so well this game in terms of farm and just keeping up with that, he has one of Twitch's like core items done, Blade of the Rune King from the very beginning. Now, he's just snowballed that into an Infinity Edge, and he is good to go. He has Distortion, so he can flash more often, and it'll give him a little bit of a movement speed bonus for about a couple seconds. So he is good to go, and the fact that he will have Heal, too, for another movement speed bonus.
It's a dangerous game for the AD carries, too, Zyrene.
Yeah.
Because you see that they are saying, well, you're building damage, I gotta build damage. They are not. You're playing against the Kayle now, who's up Void Staff, Zhonya's Lich Bane. That's two, three shots. Maybe I'm giving you credit on 3.5.
Yeah.
But these guys are playing with death right in front of them every time. So even their positioning is gonna have to be crazy here. So those choices for the AD carry is pretty crazy.
Now going for the Baron here from Curse Academy. No answer from Complexity Black because the inhibitor is down. They have to defend from the super minions. So uncontested Baron falling right into CA's hands. 7k up, 10k up in combat stats currently, just from that. Westrice has his Guardian Angel. Not sure how much good that's going to do him because he's been split pushing, teleporting into fights, and trying to pincer people off.
Mm-hmm.
Like that last fight was started off the back of Westrice, and then Bubba Dub was just in range of the spray and pray. That range is very deceptive. You think that like he's just sitting over there on the left of those trees and spraying praying.
It was past the
over.
Turret.
The turret
to
Bubba Dub is just a huge amount of range on that.
Had his positioning quite well. Mash Me was given credit in the intro video. Both Broken Shard and the rest of the team. And as we said, he himself thinks that he's the one that needs to get going. 5-3-7, picked himself up. Nice few double kills in the game on some odd plays, I gotta say. But he still got it to happen. Bringing himself up very nicely in the laning phase. We saw the 2v1 game going on here that Curse Academy didn't have half a good a push that Complexity did. They definitely had to scrape back a little bit in the early game there to make sure this was what happened. A lot of pressure now to the mid turret, Zyrene. It's going to have to be an engage. What are we looking for from Complexity Black? Who are they going to put the ball on? Who are they trying to shock with?
It's going to be Westrice. He has to get on top of Mash Me, throw the ball onto him, like that, and see if he can actually get the Shockwave in position. Because that's what Prawly's saving that baby for. He's like, I need to Shockwave Mash Me. If I don't Shockwave Mash Me, we're going to lose the fight. And Mash Me has a GA now. He's full build. He's done. He's not going to get any stronger.
Such a scary engage now. You have Pat and both Rux. Rux even easier can slice that first person, get a safeguard, dice on through, and Pat's ready to follow with the Sonic Wave. So much gap close right now. You can see Complexity Black very weary of putting themselves in range other than Orianna's ball that probably keeps throwing out for that zoning.
Trying to zone them.
Yeah.
But there's the lockup on the Rux. Trying to get some good damage. Inhibitor still not down just yet. Mash Me is cloaked. He's off on the side.
Yeah.
He's trying to come in. There he is.
Locking him down. This is going to be great. Westrice could not have asked for more right now. K1 Pro's in. Rux very
Mashmi's
low.
Going down.
It's DualSec on the outside, not really being hit up right now. Mashmi and both Robert actually are on the ground right now, and the teams have to fend
There's
for
Westrice going on Rux.
Westrice onto Rux over the wall. The slice is there. Gets himself out. I believe he was able to quickly dice as well. 2 minutes on drag, but both teams are focusing on what push they can get after this fight just happened. For Curse Academy to not really have that one altogether, Complexity Black can easily gain some ground here.
So all that credit I was giving Mashmi for his positioning, kind of opposite right there. Look at that. Shockwave right onto him. Gone. He's in GA state right now. Westrice is all on top of this, trying to do what he can. Mashmi comes back up. They try to heal him. He's gone. Robert X. Lee, he's out of the fight too, and they just chase it down. Bubba Dub trying to come up big here, but they disengage it, and Westrice, he wanted some of that Rux, but he slices and dices his way right out of there. So the positioning there, you look at it, Mash didn't get to use his heal or his flash.
No.
Just locked up in it. His GA is now just stats on him for the defense. Does no longer have that old revive available. And the fact he positioned himself so far forward, he almost ate the Dark Binding too to start the fight off.
Whoa. Rux is like, all right, let's make this happen.
He's like, I've got a thorn mail. I'm ready to rock. Robert can go ahead and kill himself
Curse
against
Academy.
My body.
Curse Academy is definitely just kind of...
Could
have autoed him and then kept him there. But wind-up time. Get some go-home. You saw how much Curse was just kind of walking onto the steps and off to the steps. Westrice was like a pixel within range, but they will not engage unless they see Mashmi. It's kind of like Blitzcrank having the hookup. Until he uses it, nobody wants to do anything. But if, like you said, once they saw Mashmi, it was over. So that ace in the hole, that card that they have to keep playing on the side of Curse Academy. Very nice push here.
Hit nobody with the Shockwave. That is not good for Complexity Black, but that's really good for Curse Academy. They can start sieging this up even harder without that fear in the back of their minds. Look at that. They don't care anymore. They're like, it's gone.
This is the lockdown. They need to fight with the turret up right now. They try to go in. It is just going to be a decimation of the turret quickly. Curse has enough time and HP to focus on the structure while taking all of these abilities right now. They kind of think it's a good time to get out. Now being reinitiated on. K1 Pro taking a nice ace.
Oh, the binding
flashes it as well. And Complexity Black with Curse standing still for that amount of time. Couldn't take one down.
And they end up losing their inhibitor just from brute force. Now two of them down on opposite sides. They have to spread themselves thin. And now the middle turret will be the next objective here after the dragon for Curse Academy, who've just been on point in terms of control of dragon and Baron all game long.
Yep. Very strong play coming from Curse Academy. They may not have had the early game upper hand with how the 2v1 swap went. As I said before, they weren't even able to grab the top tier turret when their second tier or two were dropped in the bottom lane. So that's still a lot to come back from in itself. That pros say they're doing that now because it's working with that early game gold and how the map is opened up. And Curse didn't get that early game gold. They kind of struggled there to come back, but they did a damn good job at it. Now 46-46 into our third place match. It's the first game at a best of five. It's one hell of a game so far.
Oh yeah, and a lot of people are expecting Complexity Black to come up big in this series.
Mm-hmm.
But Curse Academy, they're definitely showing that they are high contenders for this spot and putting a lot on the line. Former LCS pro, Don't Mash Me,
yep,
pulling his weight hardcore on this. He's a big target and he's got one on his back. We saw it in the intro video, Complexity Black, but we think he's the most threatening member and they focus him every time. If he's in the back line, they still just run past everybody and try to get to him.
They said if we can avoid Broken Shard's ganks in the early game, the game will be all right for us. And Broken Shard was 2 to 3 levels behind at one point because of, you know, how Complexity Black reacted to their own turret push. Kind of leaves Eve out in the wild. We'll see how Mashmi, a little close here.
He's going for it again.
Broken Shard gets hit up, but he knows the Dark Binding isn't there this time. The crowd control isn't there. Still with the hard hat on, a little crazy. 48 minutes on the clock. This one's going for the long haul. 20 seconds on to Baron. Whatever happens after this fight could mean a lot. And right now, the inhibitor in the eyes of Curse Academy.
Some damage on to Pat, but there's so much armor here that Robert X. Lee almost does nothing to these members. Two Thorn Mails, one on Rux, one on Pat. They just bruiser their way in there, and then they're like, all right, we're going to go get Baron now. See you guys.
One of those times when they need to just push in. This is only providing more chances more 50-50s for the other team to get a chance to make something happen for themselves. Mashmi makes another mistake like that. You saw it. It was a pretty prominent or a pretty good fight coming in for Complexity Black. Doesn't look like the Baron's gonna actually have anything on it. So that just kind of goes with the Complexity or Curse Academy flow, rather. 8-6 in turrets. Three more left on the map for them to take down. With that Baron being grabbed, no contest. I actually don't think Complexity can really do much here, but we'll have to see.
A lot of combat stats for Curse Academy. Coming up big on this one so far. You look at Robert X. Lee, he's 2-7-10. He's just been focused down, and they get to him a lot easier than Complexity Black gets to Mashmi. It's very slippery. They don't even need the Talisman of Ascension. They opt for the Frozen Heart
instead.
They are just countering Robert X. Lee and stopping him from carrying this game. So it's all on Westrise, who at the same time is getting shut down by a lot of those items too.
Yeah,
does some magic damage, but not the same.
Frozen Heart's still going to make a Jax pretty sad.
Oh yeah, that and the Thorn Mails too on Cat and Rux.
Double Thorn. You can see just toying with them. But look at where Westrise thinks he is as well. He wants to be the one to go out and clear. He's trying to get wards out. He does not have a sweeper right now. He's got the upgraded ward. So it looks like he's trying to get trinkets out for the team, make engagements that he can be balled in and maybe hop over the wall. A very nice three-man shockwave there. DualSec low uses the intervention. Blocking the Iron Solari also goes out.
Curse
Academy definitely worried about this fight. This is what I was talking about. Complexity with their own engagement. Rux can't afford to go in it as well. We see that the inhibitor might be going down, but Complexity has to get Curse off their front doorstep.
And now that bottom inhibitor just going to be dropped. Oh. Trying to defend it is just not enough. They already had super minions, double super minions, buffing each other, re-getting that inhibitor. Now they're just holding on for dear life. They're going to need multiple fights going in their favor. Or if they can push out of their base, go for just one death blow. If Complexity Black want to get back into this. But Curse Academy, they can go for the slow, methodical way and mash me GA up. Very, very strong. He's just doing so much work for his team, and his positioning, like 9 out of 10 times, is perfect. We're going to look at that again here. We see the shockwave. DualSec looks like he's going to go down here. And Broken Shard tries to go in and tries to get in on them, but he can't. And now Bubba Dub gets locked up and just rocked. Now Westrise comes in from the side. He runs into the box, so he decides I have to pull off and go after Rux now. He's the closest member. And he gets picked up with Ace of the Hole.
Really great positioning from Robert X. Lee that fight. Curse Academy knew, though, they had such a wave pressure on the bottom lane that we might lose a few here. Complexity is not going to be coming up without one of our turrets or anything after this. The push is just too good, and with those both being down in the side lanes, that's inevitably the mid lane falling down.
Yeah, they're just going to have to siege up, and Complexity Black, their options are very limited against Curse Academy, considering that Twitch coming back into play, back into favor, warrants a different type of play style. And really, Mashmi, if he just doesn't mess up his positioning, or Mash's positioning, mash himself into that fight, he'll be good. He will be really good. All he has to do is just stay in that outer range. The hard engage here is really just Westrise and a pinch from Broken Shard, but keep him in the base, he's never going to come from behind you.
I like how he's picked up the orb as well, making sure he can kind of figure out where any of that crowd control will be coming from, if anybody is hanging off on the side. I always see Mashmi going in by himself, which is a little scary.
Yeah, he's using the spray and pray just to get the extra range to hit the turret.
Yep. Very... This is, I was going to say, sometimes you get in your own head and you want something to happen. Using that ultimate there, it does come up quite quickly, but that almost got them caught. The Banshee's Veil keeping them safe from the initial burst of DualSec. So he's also has to look for a different target to start his Q on now if it can't be broken. A lot of little things are being mitigated here that are going to throw the fight in different ways. It'll be interesting how the teams accept that. Westrise. He's on cleanup duty right now. We got super minions coming in from both the bottom side. Top side has been thwarted by the inhibitor spawning. But we're 53 minutes in, and it's going to start be 6 items for everybody around the map.
Except for Westrise, who's sitting on a fortitude potion.
He is, yep.
Hasn't chugged it yet. Hasn't even built another item. Just wanting to have that little burst HP in a team fight. To see how it works out for him. But still, 3-7 for Robert X. Lee. Even in items, though, so he's just as strong as Mashmi in terms of build, but coming up on Champion Select here, it's definitely the Twitch who has that late game advantage with Kale in the back pocket for the intervention.
Ooh.
Once again, going after this up inhibitor in the top lane. Middle turret very low. All inhibitors are about to be open. Mash is going for it again, they catch him.
Oh my gosh, he gets the intervention right away. This is going to be the goal for Broke's fight. Westrise very low. It's going to go down. The Guardian Angel proccing for him. It's now onto Broken Shard. He goes down in the fight and will not be back to participate. Curse Academy pushing their way in. Bubba Dub with only a few shots left. They may have found the fight they finally need, and it's not even one they have Baron. It was just about the multitasking and giving Complexity Black too much to work with. They take down the middle inhibitor. They're going to take down the top one as well. They're going to grab everything they can. A 54-minute game as they make what should be the final push.
And they're going for it here. Westrise back up. He's full HP. He's coming in this. He's trying to do what he can against Mash, but his GA isn't even popped.
This is going to be bad for Westrise if he tries to go in anymore. Rux, so much damage coming in with the rest of the team. DualSec helping to crush down the HP bars and Complexity. Not having enough damage to take down Rux K1 Pro. Mash me now up off the Guardian Angel, and that is going
to be
enough damage, most likely, coming in for game one. Mash me very afraid of what can happen. Probably trying to make the dance happen. Saves himself. Too many minions onto the Nexus. K1 Pro trying to get the hits in. The spawns are coming up in 13 seconds for Broken Shard, but that's too long at 55 minutes. Game one going over to Curse Academy, and what a game.
And Complexity Black said in the intro video, Mash Me is the guy they want to look out for. And even if they're looking at him all game long, he's still coming up big. So I don't know how they're going to shut him down further. They may ban out the Twitch, but from start to finish, objective control for Curse Academy. Most of the dragons, early game falling over to them. Turrets went to Complexity Black, but they always stayed just one step ahead on Curse Academy. All the barons were theirs. Even that dragon that Pat secured through two members, flying all the way to it, picking it up for himself. It wasn't an equal trade, but still, have another dragon to their name. And that's what they did from start to finish, just Curse Academy.
That was quite big. And a lot of the fights were going in Complexity's favor after that. We saw the bottom fight where Curse picked up two or three kills, but it was Westrise that had taken the top turret there, trying to keep giving them map pressure. And then Complexity Black's map pressure fell off a little bit, and Curse Academy then started to take over.
The teleport looked like it was going to come up big for them.
Right.
But then they just pushed in on them over and over again, and Westrise was then always in the fight, always clearing a super minion wave after the inhibitor went down, and that was what his duty was from then on. He wasn't able to make it past tier one turrets at that point.
All right, let's bring up a replay from the game as well. It's the Curse Academy Baron fight. We all remember this one. Such a huge play, but Complexity Black, it's kind of a have to.
And Mash Me, he's off on the bottom side here and probably hasn't shockwaved yet, even though he could have gotten three there. Throws it on a Mash and picks him up, but just barely.
Yeah.
And they gave a lot for that. They were already down two members going into that fight, so it was a 3-on-5 in favor of Curse Academy.
Right.
And that first Baron going over to them was huge.
And really strong play as well coming from the jungle and the lanes of Curse Academy. After all that were to happen, we saw Rux 1v1ing Broken Shard on the bottom lane and a quick, what was it, a 6 to level 4, I think, because of how quickly they took advantage of Complexity Black trying to get their advantage off the quick 2v1 in the bottom lane, 2 turret push.
Yeah, Rux pushing that advantage of being Renekton in the early game against just a jungler Eve who has almost no combat stats at the beginning.
Right.
Like, I've got a Spirit Stone and a Longsword, it's about it. Up against a pickaxe, which he came up with, big for his team.
A lot of those little things in every lane, leading Curse Academy to the first win in this best of five. So with our first playoff game all wrapped up, we need to take a quick break. But when we come back, it's game two between Curse Academy and Complexity Black. Plus, I will dominate from that other Curse team. We'll be joining us here in the studio. Stick around. There's more Challenger action coming your way. Yeah, he teleported in and they saw it right away.
Oh!
It's going to be the engage. Bubba Dub very low. Gets hit up by Mash Me right on the backside. Spray and pray. He's in the perfect choke point to keep shredding the team.
But DualSec
with a beautiful flash in the save. There's, God. I don't even know how that saved him just now. 18 to 14, 38 minutes on the clock, and Mash Me's got his eyes on the inhibitor turret.